Hey my friends, welcome back. In today's video I will show you how to paint fur. You're gonna use these colors here, mix color for the underpainting, as you can see. And we don't forget to oil out the painting surface to make sure that the color is not drying too fast. And then we build up the background quickly. Very simple blue sky. And we also apply the color for the main figure here. Already trying to establish the different values and already trying to get in the shape right as best as possible. Yeah, that's how it looks like. Let it dry and then we grab the next set of colors and start to mix basically the final set of colors. And after the painting is dry, the first layer, we start to build up the detail parts. See, I have on my computer screen the reference photo. And yeah, one of the key parts when it comes to painting fur is that we do not paint every single hair. We basically hint more or less the detail that is there. It's the horn part we're gonna paint. It's clear dark color on the lower end and getting lighter on the upper part here. I'm already starting to add those fine little details here. Readjusting the colors here and there. And also adding those very fine lines that you have when it comes to painting horn. Yeah, and then we proceed with the head. And again, I'm putting in the colors. Not very detailed. But on the outer edges, I already try to build up those detail parts, those hair that extend, and they will really help to communicate this fairy character of this part of the painting. Colors pretty much thinned down, as you can see. It's kind of a thick glaze. And then they basically just build up the volume using very dark colors in places. We have a lot of contrast in this painting here. It's a very small painting, but it took quite a while to finish. But it's not an easy thing to paint the fur. But with the way I show you here, it's not that difficult anymore, I think. Basically just building the base values, those shapes, the darker colors that you have on your reference photo. And adding some lighter tones, lighter colors, where we have those parts that are more in the foreground, more or less. Here you see me building up already the final details. And don't forget, the color that we put on is still wet, so that we have a very nice connection between those colors, and it makes also the process of detailing the hair, I think, easier. And of course you can do it with a dry brush technique, thinning down the colors a bit more and basically put on the color on the dry surface. But in this case I decided to Yeah, apply the color on the still wet surface that we have here. And it came out not too bad, I think. But also make sure that you don't use too much color for the underpainting. I mean, not the underpainting that is dry, but the layer of color that we put on before we applied now these fine details here. It's already starting to get some shape, as you can see here. Yeah, and the snout part was another very important thing here. You see me basically constantly readjusting the values, the colors, adding some more detail here and there, and basically this part here is emerging from the dark color we have around it. So it looks at the moment, now it starts to look better. Yeah, you need to make sure that it's connecting with the dark color and that it's really kind of emerging from this darker surrounding color here. There's lots of fine detail parts here, all those very fine color variations, and the lips and the mouth itself. Going back and readjusting the value here and there to give it a bigger and better 3D effect. Any more details? Yeah, and see, it took quite a while to get in this micro detail here, more or less. But I think this really makes it stand out a bit. Much more realistic. And here again, I show you the basically that I just tint those hair. I extend the hair over the edge of this animal here. While I'm not applying these detail in the center stage or in the main part of the animal. I mean, later on I will add some little details here and there, as you can see, but there's no need when it comes to painting fur that you paint basically every single hair. Just hinting it and then you're fine. Here you see I'm using the first layer basically as a starting point and just apply those hair detail. And this is enough to get the impression of this fairy character in. You know, again in detail and time lapse the process of building up those hair. And we also have this part here on the painting where we have a very strong wind, and this is you see basically that the hair is pressed against the body of this little cow, and this helps to communicate this this stormy cold climate that we have here on the painting. You see before it's basically a snow scene. Some wind, and again I'm just hinting more or less those fur details. And let me start to build up the background. As you can see, the grass again thinned down quite a bit. Let me connect the legs with the background, and finally we apply the snow. Bit of a bluish, whitish color here. Basically a repetition of the color of the sky. Put in very rough. And after we put that in, we add some more grass detail and we're finished. Make sure not to forget to check out one of these two videos here.